I once heard music described as organized noise. Well, then that would make the fable rationalized fear. Now, the Francis Ellis Mysteries is a fable, a Gothic fable, and all that that entails, fear of the unknown, fear of the other, fear of what we may do. Francis Vincent Ellis is a survivor. He survived the race riot of Chicago, 1919. He survived working in the Union stockyards. He survived a segregated Navy. He survived the Second World War. He survived the blast on July night in 1944 on Port Chicago. Now, skip forward to 1949, and he's a man living in seclusion, but he's plucked out of that seclusion by a chance to find out if that explosion on that pier was indeed an accident. And he is thrust into a world of metahumans and hyperreality and guile and seduction and corruption, conspiracy. Now, the idea is to find out if it was an accident or if it was a trap. But what's more frightening still, he finds out what he's capable of doing in that search.
Francis Vincent. A man approaches.
Does he wish to do me harm?
He wishes to know the truth.
Every fool thinks he does.
Hi, I'm Caro Pose, and I'm the producer of the Francis Ellis Mysteries. Michael and I have worked together in many, many projects. And this one in particular brought us together with two different cultures, his culture here in Chicago and mine from South America. I grew up in Colombia, and fotonovelas were one of those things that you always saw in the newsstands. And we decided to bring it together and create the Francis Ellis Mysteries. With some of the historical interests that he has, especially in Chicago, and blending some of the new technology, we came up with Francis Ellis and created a motion panel book.
Francis Ellis falls within the sort of film noir genre, and it's a genre that really was at its height in the 1940s. And they were sort of an outgrowth of the German expressionist films, chiaroscuro lighting, that sort of interplay of light and shadow and the way that they were composing the frames and lighting the subjects. And that reflected the shadowy world that the characters inhabited. And that, sort of tapped into these sort of, again, primal fears that had existed since the 1400s when the fairy tales were written, you know, the sort of Hansel and Gretel type stories.
What is exciting about film noir, what is exciting about the Francis Ellis Mysteries, is that it's mythology in which the audience is allowed to take a part, allowed to fill in.
But what Francis Ellis is doing is it's pushing that envelope even further. It's taking it from the page to the screen, and instead of having to think about reading your comic on the screen, your comic is on the screen, but it's being acted out. It's moving. It's living. It's a living thing. It is taking grim fairy tales. It's taking the H.P. Lovecraft genre of like horror. It's taking that psychological horror. It's taking that psychological myth. It is taking that thing. It's putting it in the backdrop of Chicago in the 1940s jazz scene. It's giving you the seedy backdrop. It's giving you a living, breathing city with living, breathing people. It is a comic book that moves, that evolves on your screen.
And that's what is incredible. You actually have to observe and take the time to enjoy the beauty of the photography, the detail of the animation. Listen to the sound mix and all the sound effects.
You know, it was a lot of fun doing something completely different. Because especially actors of my generation don't really get a chance to do that very much. It's all, you know, quick shots, film and rolling and everything. So to capture those moments kind of in stillness was such a different experience.
We had to do acting as well as just pose for photos, because it has to move like a story.
Gozi is a vor, half man and half wolf.
This project, the Francis Ellis Mysteries, combines like modeling, voice work, acting, obviously, and so many elements. It's nothing like I've ever seen before.
I think this is a very unique project that incorporates a lot of things that I really enjoy. I really enjoy comic books. I really enjoy like the whole anti-hero in a sense.
We have completed principal photography of Frances Ellis. We completed also all the dialogue recordings. Before launching this crowdsourcing, we wanted to make sure that we had a sample that we could show to the world and say, this is what we're doing, because there's nothing out there that we can compare it to. So this project is a pioneering way of storytelling. We are breaking some ground, and we need your support. Anything you can help us with would be enough to take us to the next level. If you enjoy storytelling, I think Frances Ellis is for you. Thank you for your support.